One of the aspects of getting the most performance out of any race car is the wheel alignment. Regardless of how much money you've got tied up in your car, it really comes down to the contact patch between those four tyres that's going to define how fast or how slow your lap is. And when it comes to making changes at the track, this can be a little bit tricky, particularly if you are relying on a wheel alignment specialist. It's hard to take your wheel alignment specialist along to the track. Now we're here with Cole from Life Motorsport at Sydney Motorsport Park with the Life Motorsport R35 GTR to find out how they deal with it. Now, Cole, you've already had a pretty good start to World Time Attack 2019, resetting the R35 lap record. What have you just run?
Ran a 130.0, so a couple seconds faster than our previous record, and it's just the tip of the iceberg.
So dangerously close to the 29s.
Oh, that's all I wanted. You know, if I could go 29.9, I'd be happy. So just being that close right out of the chute is pretty good. We know we got more in it. The data shows I lost about a second with driver-induced errors. So that's why we're looking at every bit of the car to squeeze the most out of it.
Okay, so when you've got a car that's making a lot of horsepower, albeit it's also pretty heavy, that wheel alignment really does come down to being absolutely critical. So I've just watched your crew there go through and perform a string wheel alignment. And I want to start by just talking about what you're actually looking for. What makes you decide on a particular change to your alignment, be that toe or camber?
Well, that really depends on where you start. You know, you got to rough it in. And we know a lot about this car. We know how different handling characteristics and different changes affect it as far as magnitude of change. And we've really roughed in the car, we've got it working really well, and so we've aligned the car probably six times in the past few days. So really just dialing the thing in. A lot of that is data collected from the car, tire temperatures, shock potentiometers, and then ultimately it's the driver's decision on what does the driver want the car to do in a particular corner. So we take that feedback, put it together, and come up with some logical change.
So a lot of that you've built there from experience. I mean, you're no stranger to this particular car. You've been racing it competitively and winning for years in the car. So you've got that sort of background of data of what sort of camber and toe numbers, for example, you're likely to want for a given track. But you just talked about tyre temperatures. So can you talk about how you're using that tyre temperature data, what that data is telling you, and how you then interpret that and apply it to a particular change?
Yeah, so it's what you want to ultimately do, the easiest way to say it, is use all the tyre. So we want to see an even tyre temperature spread across the entire tyre. So we'll use a tyre pyrometer that actually goes into the carcass of the tyre that can read accurately the temperature that you're using the tire across the way. So you're working the tire more, it's going to create more heat. And we just go back and check it every single time to make sure that we're using all of the tire and maximizing the grip on each particular corner of the car.
Now, I just want to clarify here, because when you're talking about a tire pyrometer, we're talking about a specialized tool made solely for the job of checking the tire tread temperature. So the important part here is that that tire pyrometer is actually inserted below the tread surface. So can you tell us how that's important compared to the likes of the basic, relatively cheap infrared temperature sensors that we see people use for maybe the temperature of the cooling system or something like that on the car?
Right. So you'll see people measure with an infrared tire pyrometer, and very in a professional fashion, they'll do it live and they'll be able to see live tire data. That's the right way to use an infrared tire pyrometer. We use a traditional tire pyrometer where the probe goes into the rubber. And so we're not on the surface. The surface cools quickly, whereas the inside of the tire, you get a lot more accurate reading of what's really happening. So the probe actually inserts into the tire. I don't know what it is in millimeter, probably an eighth of an inch, a little bit more.
About 3 millimeters, give or take.
Yeah, something like that. And that way we get a good reading of what the core of the tire's temps are going up to.
When you're using a tire pyrometer like this, it's still quite important to be specific in the way you come into the pit. So you don't want to be on a cool down lap and allow that temperature to stabilize. It still does stabilize quite quickly, so it's important to come into the pits on a hot lap.
Absolutely, you got to bring it in hot if you want accurate data. So you're pushing all the way to the very last corner until you get into the pits, get here as quickly as possible, and you're grabbing the data immediately. So it's something that changes so quickly. That's why a lot of guys with the budgets and technology, they're measuring it live, and that's ultimately what you want. So the closest thing we can do that with the technology we have is bring it into the pits hot.
All right, so once you've decided, based on that temperature profile that you're seeing with your tyre pyrometer, what changes to make, this is the tricky bit because a lot of people are relying on a wheel alignment specialist. Now, you're using a string alignment system here with a ruler, and I know to a lot of people this might look like a backyardish option, but the reality is anything but. We see this used in the upper echelons of motorsport. Can you tell us about that system and why you choose to use it?
It's accurate, it's easy to transport, and it's the standard of motorsport. You know, I've seen Formula One cars aligned with strings, so it's accurate, repeatable, and it's right in front of you. So it's the best way that we know how to do it.
All right, Cole, look, it's been interesting to get some insight into that. Hopefully the alignment checks that you've just made and any changes you're about to apply work, and we wish you all the best getting into the 29s this weekend. Thanks for the chat.
I appreciate it, man.